mechanical and aerospace engineer Philip Watts from California. Marine biologist Frank Fish from Pennsylvania. And filmmaker and entrepreneur Stephen Dewar from Toronto. Three men thousands of miles apart. So what connects them all?
We all love the sea and we all love animals.
We're all interested in the relationship between biology and technology.
We all wanted to build something new and sustainable. We founded a company we called
Whale Power.
Efficient turbine blades, copied from nature. It was a chance occurrence over 35 years ago that ultimately led to the invention on which their company is based.
I was on vacation in Boston and went into this shop that had all this animal art. And in the center of the shop was a pedestal with a little figurine of humpback whales. And I looked at that and I saw that the leading edge of the flippers of the humpback had these bumps on them. And that made no sense compared to what I knew about fluid mechanics and just looking at airplanes. You always have a straight leading edge. And so I had to know what was going on with these whales and why they had these curious bumps.
From then on, the question really got him thinking. He watched humpback whales in the water. They glide and turn lightly and elegantly on their own axis, even though they're as large and as heavy as a bus. 7 years later, Fish had the chance to examine the flipper of a stranded humpback. He felt that the bump on the flipper, called a tubercle, was somehow related to the whale's swimming skills.
For the humpback whale, having the tubercles delays stall to higher angles, and so the whale can develop lift and thus turn tightly. If it didn't have the tubercles and its flipper stalled, it would be like driving on a road that's covered by ice, and when you take a turn, instead of following the curve, what would happen is you would go off tangentially.
He recreated the almost 2-meter-long flipper on the computer and also made an X-ray image. His hypothesis was confirmed, but how could he prove it?
And I went around to a number of people, and I got some interest, but I never got much interest at all. And then what happened is I met this person, Phil Watts.
Phil Watts is not a biologist, but an engineer. A man who loves the sea and loves animals. With his expertise in mechanical engineering and in aviation, he was just the man for the job.
I had already been working in biomechanics, and so I understood the importance of biomimicry, about drawing engineering ideas from evolution. And when Frank shared that humpback whales were the only whales that had bumpy leading edges on their flippers, I immediately realized that that could have some important engineering consequences. So I ran some fluid dynamic simulations of wings with tubercles and wings without tubercles. And the tubercles increased the lift and simultaneously reduced the drag. And for an engineer who works on wing performance, that's a spectacular achievement, to be able to increase the lift and reduce the drag at the same time.
Further investigations followed, now with several researchers involved. Soon it became clear that these were bumps with benefits.
Tubercles focus the flow between the bumps, and that focused flow helps keep the flow attached to the wing, and it also helps isolate the lift in between the tubercles. So if you have a bump here and a bump here, we're going to get a high lift region in between.
And what improved the performance in the water could also bring big benefits in the air.
And so what the tubercles do is they prevent the flipper or any wing from stalling. A stall is when the wing or flipper would lose its lift. Now, for a whale, that's not a big deal because the animal is neutrally buoyant in the water. So it's not going to fall out of the water. For a plane, if it stalls, then you start falling out of the sky.
The marine biologist and the engineer jointly published their research results. and they formulated a first patent for tubercle technology. 700 kilometers away, Canadian journalist and entrepreneur Stephen Dewar read about their work and was instantly captivated.
I was struck by the fact that this totally changed what we thought we understood about flow management. I was so taken by this that I tried to contact the scientists. So I called Frank and Phil, and we were talking about how this all worked. And I asked them what they were doing with it commercially. They called me back the next day and said, can we set up a company with you? And we were off and running.
The Whale Power team developed prototypes and tested them. They measured 20% energy savings, improved efficiency, greater stability, and greater durability as a result. A second patent was filed, this time covering Europe, the US, and several other countries.
Our tests have shown that blades with tubercles are more energy efficient and quieter than standard blades. And so we can use this for applications such as wind turbines, fans, compressors, and pumps.
Our plans with Whale Power were to make designs and prototypes that could demonstrate the technology, which we would license to manufacturers. And that's what we've been doing.
From small fans for cooling computers to larger ceiling-mounted fans, retrofit models for turbines and wind farms, and much more. One is already under license, the others are planned for the future. Tubercle technology is both sustainable and unique, and it owes its existence to three men who were inspired by the secrets of nature.
From animals, we can learn so much. We just have to look carefully.
Tubercles are a technology for the future. They'll allow us to create a sustainable planet and allow future generations to thrive.
We were able to get an understanding of what was possible because nature had done so much work on this.